Hi everyone, and welcome back to our channel. In today's video, we're going to take a look at the asset management Odoo module developed by Openinside. This module allows managing assets owned by a company or a person, keeps track of depreciation, and creates corresponding journal entries. The Assets Management module allows you to keep track of your fixed assets, like machinery, land, and buildings. The module will enable you to generate monthly depreciation entries automatically, get a depreciation board, sell or dispose of assets, and perform reports on your company assets. Odoo's standard asset management module streamlines the control and oversight of your company's fixed assets. Track depreciation, generate journal entries, and gain valuable insights into machinery, land, and building assets effortlessly, enhancing your business efficiency. Let's get started with our demo. To begin, enter the accounting module and navigate to the configuration menu. From here, click on the asset type option within the management section. The process is straightforward. We will create templates for one-time use and associate them with a specific asset. Once these templates are configured, whenever we utilize the corresponding assets, the system will automatically apply the predefined configuration from the associated template. In this demonstration, we will use the example of computers. From this template, we have to specify the asset type. Then the journal entries, we can specify a miscellaneous journal or assets, which is also the type of miscellaneous. Then you choose the accounts. Select the asset account. Depreciation entries asset account. Depreciation entries expense account. From the periodicity, we have to either choose it to be based on the number of entries or based on the ending date. The number of entries option will fix the number of entries and the time between two depreciations. While the ending date uses the time between two depreciations and the date the depreciation won't go beyond. Now, we will enter the number of entries and specify how many entries will be generated and how often. In the additional option, we can check the auto confirm asset box if we want the system to automatically confirm the asset of this category when it is created through bills. You can also check the Group Journal Entries box if you want to group the generated entries, providing a more organized view. Additionally, if you want to create a separate record for each quantity, you can check the Create Record for Each Quantity box. From the depreciation method. Here, we can select the depreciation method, whether if it is linear or degressive. And here, the prorata temporis, we can indicate the first depreciation entry for this asset have to be done from the purchase date instead of the first of the month. Now, after setting all these configurations, we have to move on to create a new product in the inventory module. Tap on Products menu. Click on New. Add the product name, Computers. Then specify here if it can be sold and can be purchased. Under the Accounting tab, we can set the asset type, which is the template we have just created. Then save. Now we will enter the Purchase module to create a purchase order. Click on New. Select the vendor. Then select the product, which is computer. Type the price under Unit Price. Then confirm the order. Let's assume that we received the products. We will validate it to process all quantities. Now we will create the bill. Select the bill date. In the account field, we have to select the configured account in the template. In our case, we will select the fixed asset account. We can view the assets through this smart button. We will see that there is a new record here, which is computer 1. And it has linked to the category of computers and linked to the vendor and the bills. Click on the record to view the depreciation board. Here are the gross value, salvage value, and residual value. Here under the depreciation board, we can view the sequence, depreciation date, cumulative depreciation, depreciation, and residual. The red sign here means it is unposted. And if it is orange, it means it is in a draft. And if it is green, it means it is posted. Let's see the effect of changing the linked sign. Click on it. As we can see, the item's smart button is shown here. Click on it to see the depreciation entries linked to the record, which affected the depreciation expense account on the debit side, and the fixed assets account on the credit side. So it increased the expense and decreased the fixed asset. If all the linked signs are green, the record will automatically move to done. And there you have it. You've reached the end of our tutorial on the Assets Management module developed by Openinside. We wish this video has given you straightforward instructions on how to use this tool. If you enjoyed this video and want to explore more of Openinside's Odoo module tutorials, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to stay updated. Thank you, and see you in our next video.